Hello everyone. So today in this video I'm going to discuss about simple microscope. So simple microscope is consists of only a single convex lens. So we'll discuss its magnifying power. Let's say this is the principal axis, and we know that if we'll keep the object, let's say this is the focal focus, in between focus and the optical center, if we'll keep the object, then a virtual image will be produced. A virtual image will be produced. An enlarged virtual image will be produced. And if we'll keep the object on F, then the image will be produced at infinity. So we will calculate the magnification for both the cases. One is, we will calculate the magnification at near point. Near point means at a distance 25 centimeter, that is called the minimum distance of for clear vision. So if the image will be produced at the distance d, capital D is 25 centimeter, that is your minimum distance for the clear vision. Okay. So when the image will be formed here, or your V will be this one, then we will calculate the magnification, and your magnification will come up as 1 plus D by F. So how will you get this expression? By simple calculation, that we know that magnification is M is equal to V upon U, right. Now image, let us say the image will be produced. So 1 by U I can write V into 1 by U, I can write 1 by V minus 1 by F. This one I can write, right. Now if we'll multiply, we'll get 1 minus V by F. Now when the image will be produced at this D, that is 25 centimeter from the eye, the minimum distance for clear vision, that is near point, it's called near point. Okay, where near point means D will be equal to, so your V will be equal to D, that is 25 centimeter. So I'll replace this near point, and we are getting a virtual image in the left side. So according to sign convention, will have a minus D. So your magnification will be 1 minus V will be minus D by F, or you can say 1 plus D by F. So this is your proof of the first expression, that when the object is kept at a distance, let us say U, which is in between O and F, optical center and the focus, then we will adjust this object in such a way that the image should be produced at D, 25 centimeter, so that the magnification will be 1 plus D by F. Now let us say take the another case, the case for angular magnification, and the image will be produced at infinity. So for that what we will do, image produced at infinity, that means this is case 2, your V will be at infinity, minus infinity or infinity, it will be in the left side. So when the image will be formed at infinity, now for a convex lens, if we will keep the object at focus, when your U is equal to minus F, then your image, this one will pass through the focus and another ray will, optical center will be undeviated. So your image, if we'll extend to the back side, it will also parallel. So image will be produced at infinity. Now in between D and infinity, the image is visible to us, or we can see the image clearly. If image will be formed less than 25 centimeter, we will not able to see the image clearly. So the image formed between D and infinity, okay, is visible to us clearly, and image at infinity is more comfortable for our eyes. To see the image at infinity or far away from us is more comfortable for our eye. Comfortable for our eye, right? So this type of magnification we will calculate angular magnification, that we will calculate theta I by theta 0, theta object, that is called angular magnification we will calculate. Okay, what is theta I and theta 0? Theta 0 is to see the object in naked eye without any lens. Let's say lens is here, let's say the object is here, you are observing from here. So this angle is theta 0 from your naked eye without any lens, that is the theta 0. It is subtend, it is making the angle with the ground, that is theta 0, and this is your height of the object, right? This is theta 0. So if I say tan theta will be, or tan theta 0 will be p by b, so h by the distance. The distance is, let's say, minimum distance where you can see the object, that is, let's say, d, okay, h by d, or this is equal to simply theta 0, because for small angle we can write that sin theta is also theta, tan theta is also theta. For small angles, for theta small, we can use this approximation that sin theta tends to theta and tan theta also tends to theta. So it is approximately theta 0. What is theta I then? Theta I is the angle when the image is produced at infinity, right? So this is your theta I, this is your theta I. So then what is theta I? So tan theta I is, image is at produced at infinity, so you can say image is produced at infinity somewhere, that is, let's say, h prime by that is, h prime is the image height divided by the distance. Let's say this distance is minus b, okay, this distance is minus b, height is h prime, the image height. So this is your theta I. Now what I can write h prime? I know that magnification is h prime by h, which equal to v by u for a lens. Here we can write that h prime is equal to v by u into h. So I'll replace this one, I'll replace this one, tan theta I. So I'll get tan theta I equal to h prime, I am getting v by u h, okay, by minus b, v b cancelled out. So I am getting minus h upon u, and this is theta I, approximately this is equal to theta I, because tan theta I is equal to theta I. Okay, so I am getting this. Now my magnification is theta I upon theta, not, that is for the without the lens, the norm vision or the angle that subtends here theta 0. So now theta I got minus h upon u, theta 0 is h by d. Now what is h by u here? When theta I is for the image produced at infinity, and for that we are keeping the object at focus, then only we are getting the image at infinity. So your u will be replaced for theta I, your u will be replaced as minus f. Your u will be replaced as minus f. So minus h by minus f, this is h by f. Okay, theta I is equal to h by f. So this one I'll write here, you can write u is equal to minus f, this is for theta I. Okay, for v equal to infinity, u is equal to minus f. So here I'll replace, so m will equal to minus h by u is h by f divided by h by d, h cancel, d will go up to the numerator, f will come down, so this will be d by f. So now we have proved two equations. One is the object which is in between f and o, image will be produced at d, your magnification is 1 plus d by f, and when the image is produced at infinity, your angular magnification, this is angular magnification, is d by f. Here this means when the image will be produced at infinity, we can see the image clearly without any strain on our eyes. So this magnification also will use in compound microscope for eyepiece. Okay, so we are getting here d by f, here we are getting 1 plus d by f. For angular magnification, image produced at infinity, we are getting d by f. That means angular magnification is 1 less than your magnification for image produced at d, right? So I hope the derivation is clear. If you have any doubt in the derivation, you can ask me in the comment box. I tried to explain as simple as possible. So thank you for watching the video. See you in another video. Bye bye.